Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Chelsey Ellis. I am a Kenra educator, and I'm so excited because tonight we're going to be doing a little styling with our beautiful model, Jenny. So we already did some fun color placement on her, and really the focus tonight is going to be color protection during heat styling. So as you can see, she already has these really fun curls going on, but I wanted to show you guys what it looked like before I broke it down. So I'm also gonna show you how to create this curl. We're gonna do a half up, half down style, and then we're gonna transition it into a full up style. So I can't wait. I hope you guys are ready to get started. Please remember this is live, so definitely ask me questions about anything that pops up. I'm so excited to hear all your guys' questions and give you some fun answers. So, should we get started? Let's do it. So we're gonna start first. I created these curls by taking a U-shaped subsection all the way throughout her hair. So in the front, it's gonna be diagonal back. So I did leave this last panel here so that you guys could see exactly how we created these curls. So we're going to start by taking diagonal back sections. And whenever you have a hard time, I know that one of my issues when I first started doing hair was I could never remember diagonal back, diagonal forward. So I always think about metaphorically putting a little marble at the top of my parting. And whichever way that marble would roll to is the direction of my angle. So this would be a diagonal back placement. And I'm going to visually kind of subsection this first one. So I think I'm gonna do about two. The really, really important thing that you wanna remember is you definitely wanna make all of your sections, whether you make them really tiny or a little bit larger, they all need to be consistent. That's gonna help you create a really beautiful, glamorous wave. So I love, love, love doing like fun beachy waves, but I definitely wanted to show something a little bit different. And I wanted to go with something a little bit more classic and a little bit more clean. So I went ahead and sprayed with our amazing new Color Maintenance Thermal Spray. So you guys seen this before? Love it. I love the fragrance. It's actually jasmine, I was just told. And it adds just such a lovely air to the hair. So I'm gonna start with my iron. I did create the curls all going the same way. So I'm gonna go over the top. And I made sure to really coat the hair with my Color Maintenance Spray. So I'm gonna go over the top, and as I twist, I'm gonna make sure that I'm spacing out my curl nicely. So that way I'm getting a nice consistent heat throughout. So it is fall. We do have our clients asking for some deeper tones, hopefully some warmer tones. I really love kind of pumpkin spice, cinnamon, ginger. I love all of those kind of descriptors for fall.
We have a couple people asking, what are we doing tonight?
Oh, so we're doing some fun thermal styling. Thanks for joining, guys. And right now we're showcasing our Color Maintenance Thermal Spray. So this has a hold of an 11. If you're not familiar with Kenra products, you're gonna find the hold factor listed right here. So we go from zero being treatments, oils, serums, conditioners, all the way up to 30, which is our ultra freeze. And that is like, you don't want that to go anywhere. So at an 11, this is a nice, soft, flexible hold. And again, I'm just gonna create this curl. So I'm holding it in my hand and just kind of twisting it just once over. And then the same as I move down the strand.
So you're doing a half up, half down.
Correct. And then a full up style. So right now I'm just showing you guys how we created these beautiful curls that we've set most of her hair with.
Perfect. What iron are you using?
Oh, I'm using an amazing T3 iron. I am using the clipless, so I'm using my wand just because I feel like for this style, for this method, I feel like it's a little bit easier to loop around and the clip's not getting in the way. Typically, I love to use a Marcel, but just depends on the technique we're using.
And what size is that one?
This one, I believe, is a one inch. So again, I'm gonna make sure to coat my section really well with my Color Maintenance Thermal Spray. So the most important thing, especially with our clients that are getting darker or going for kind of deeper, more vibrant tones for fall, is really that color protection, right? Especially if they are going over from being blonde, like Jenny was. We actually transitioned her into this beautiful red color today, and I'm just so obsessed with it because she looks like a natural redhead. But we wanna make sure that we're maintaining that color. So heat protection is gonna be really important, especially when we get into the holidays. Our clients are gonna be doing a lot of styling. I'm sure there's a lot of parties. Everyone's gonna be flat ironing, curling their hair, and they're really turning up their irons extremely hot, right? We're always having to tell our clients to turn it down a little bit. Well, what's nice about the thermal protecting spray is that it's actually gonna give me heat protection up to 450 degrees. And really, we shouldn't be putting our irons any higher than that. So I'm just looping that hair strand around, creating a nice little curl. You can really see how much shine is in her hair, and I just love that about the spray.
Yeah, it's very shiny.
It just gives like such a nice little bounce on these curls. So our Color Maintenance Thermal Spray is gonna give you thermal protection up to 25 passes. So really protecting your client's hair in between their color services. So they can do 25 different styles on their hair using their heat tool. So you can use this with a curling iron or with a flat iron. And I love that it has that nice, quick, easy release. So you're noticing that it's not sticking to my iron. It's not creating any buildup. And I wanna make sure to spray the top and the bottom, especially if you're going in with a flat iron because it's gonna be clamping on both sides. Where it's really, really important is when we have like those clients with metallic, pastels, or vibrant. You really wanna lock that color in. We know heat protection is so, so important.
That's a great tip. I think some people really forget to do both sides, but they're going to be using the iron on both sides.
Exactly. And what I even do before too, especially if it's like a special occasion, I really wanna lock in that curl, is I'll do a spray all over first. So I'll go all the way throughout and then I'll brush through and then I'll do section by section again. Just so I'm making sure that I'm really coating the hair and protecting it. But see, it's nice and brushable. It's not getting stuck to my iron, but it is giving me some nice control and some nice hold.
Jennifer is asking, does the spray have a hold?
Yes, it does have a flexible hold of 11. So if you missed earlier, I was just talking about the hold scale for Kenra products. They go from a 0 all the way up to a 30. So 30 is like not brushable. We don't want to move that hair. That's to really solidify a style. 11 is going to be nice and flexible. So it's still going to be really brushable.
Like
have some nice
medium
movement.
Medium flexible, yeah. You would say, right?
Medium flexible. I like that. So I'm on my last one. And I always I love how this looks when it's first set because it's very like curly Sue.
Very curly. So why do you not brush out the curls right away?
I don't brush out the curls right away because I want to let them cool down. One thing I think that we do too quickly is we start to brush through them when they haven't set. When they're still hot, they're going to be pliable. So you want to let that curl cool off, and then we're going to brush it out. It just helps lock in that shape a little bit better, and it helps for a longer lasting curl.
Perfect. Everyone is loving this red color.
Oh, so beautiful. Okay, so now we have our section all set. And I'm going to go through and I'm going to just break it up a little bit first with my hands and I'm going to use a wet brush. I like to use a wet brush just because it's not going to put a ton of tension on her hair But see how that curl just really locked in, and ooh, look at how shiny. Oh my gosh, I'm just in love.
So beautiful.
It's beautiful, right? She looks like a natural redhead. I keep been saying it all day. I'm like,
gorgeous color.
So I'm really creating this beautiful, you know, soft wave. And it's funny to see such a soft wave after coming out of curls so tight. But that's why I like to do them a little bit tighter, because that gives me a little bit of flexibility to kind of go through and pull them down a little. But look at how beautiful. You can really see that dimension in her color too, which I just love.
Jody is saying she loves that the Color Maintenance Thermal Spray is an aerosol.
Oh, she's, me too.
She's currently using hot spray, but would love to try an aerosol.
Oh, well, you're going to love this one. And what I like about it too is it's also a soft hold, so I can really go in there and layer it with other products too. I don't feel like I'm kind of using the strongest hold right away. So it gives me some bounce and flexibility, but look at how pretty and soft her hair looks.
You still run your fingers through it. Mm-hmm. It's
easily brushable. I'm not pulling her hair out. You're comfortable, right, Jenny? Mm-hmm. I don't want to cause any discomfort. So really kind of just creating that formation of that curl and just letting that wave kind of sit in. Now that I've let this side sit a little bit, I'm going to come back through. But you definitely want to let those curls cool off before you go and brush through, or else you're going to brush out your whole curl.
Someone's asking, how do I get a job like this?
Oh my goodness. You know, I am a big believer in manifesting things. So I always wanted to educate, and I just knew that I was going to take whatever path I could. But you know what? It takes a lot of practice. I think you definitely want to stay behind the chair for a little bit and get that experience, and then start looking, like, find a brand that you're loyal to. Get out there and offer to help with different photo shoots or make connections online. I think that we are so lucky to have such great resources right at our fingertips. And really making those connections in our community are going to open up so many doors for you.
Excellent advice.
Love it. All right. So are we loving this wave so far? Oh,
loving it.
I'm going to grab a couple more products.
They're asking, what brush and spray are you using?
Perfect. So I was literally just using a very simple, just a wet brush. So any wet brush that you have, of course, CosmoProf has an amazing variety that you can pick up. But something that doesn't have a lot of tension. I want something that's just going to run through. I am going to go through and kind of manipulate the hair a little bit more. So I want to make sure that I'm leaving enough curl in there. So next thing I'm going to apply is going to be our dry oil conditioning mist.
Awesome.
So beautiful. So it gives lots of lovely shine. Her hair's already really nice and shiny, but I want to just give it a little bit of softness. And it's going to give me a little bit more manageability as well. But look at how that just, oh, I love how it really highlights that wave. Beautiful. And let me turn her around. I really want you to see how this wave came out around her face, because it's just really cool.
Gorgeous.
What do you guys think? I mean, I almost just like this style just like this, but we got to do more than just that. Gotta give you some more fun stuff. So
beautiful.
I know. So fun. So the dry oil conditioning mist just adds instant softness and shine without weighing the hair down, which I love. I always like to go in with a shine spray or a conditioning mist. Anything that has oils, I want to put that on before I go in and put my final hairspray or my final holding product on there. Because the oils can actually go in there and kind of break up your hold a little bit. So make sure that's not the last thing you put on the hair if you're looking for a little bit more hold. So next thing I'm going through with a little bit of our dry volume burst. And this one has a hold of a 3, so very, very light. But what I love about it is it just gives me that instant kind of pop. Look how I'm getting that instant volume. Has a nice little bit, I guess I want to say grit. It almost gives you like that second day hair. You know, when your hair just feels so good and it's like holding the style so nice, it always looks better the next day. This is how to get that next day hair on the first day.
Yeah. Some excellent volume at the roots.
Oh, love it.
Someone else wants to know, what spray were you using while curling it?
Oh, while curling. Okay, so that was our color maintenance thermal spray. So that is our thermal protectant, and it is going to protect their hair and their color predominantly from fading. So again, I'll just show you guys that one, our thermal spray, color maintenance, and it has a medium hold. I also love, I don't know if you guys have seen this actuator, but it's really cool. I love how this locks. So when I have it pushed over, it's locked, and then to unlock it, I just switch it over to that side. But it's perfect. Really fantastic.
Super easy while traveling too.
Oh, yes. So I just went through and put a little bit of our dry volume burst in. And now we're gonna start with our half up style. So I'm liking the product feel that I have in there right now. I've given myself a little bit of grit. See how I can almost kind of just like pop her hair up? Look at how weightless it looks.
I just love that.
So we're gonna first start by taking a horseshoe section right through the top of the crown. And I like to use the arches of the eyebrow kind of as my little point of reference of how wide to go. Because everybody has different head shapes, different hairlines, but I feel like that's pretty universally flattering on everybody.
That's an excellent tip. Because I feel like a lot of people don't know where to take that chunk of hair for the half up.
Definitely.
So it's a really great tip. So top of the arch of the eyebrow, right?
Exactly. So I'm gonna start by taking my section. And if I have a little bit of hair falling out in the front, I kind of like that. I especially like it because she's got this beautiful like pop, this wave right here. And I wanna kind of let that happen. So if I wanna let some other little pieces kind of fall down, I like how that looks too. Mm-hmm. That's gonna be really fun. Okay, so I'm gonna start with my section. And I'm gonna use just a tiny bit of our Kenra flexible fiber. So if you guys have tried this one before, this has a hold of an 11 as well. And it has this really nice kind of fibrous, like gummy texture. So I don't know if you can see that in there. I'm just gonna take a tiny bit and I'm gonna run this through the ends. So why I'm doing this is because I'm gonna create an infinity braid and I wanna have a little bit of control. And this is just gonna help me smooth out any little flyaways or get any of those little baby hairs. I'm gonna keep that nice and soft. So just really light and working that in through the ends. Constantly look at yourself in the mirror too. That's one thing I think I forget a lot is that I have a mirror in front of me for a reason. It's not just for my model to admire herself. It's also for me to look at to make sure that I'm keeping a balance and that I'm liking how the shape is looking in front. So I'm gonna start with two sections. So I'm gonna break my little horseshoe up into two, and then I'm gonna take a little piece of hair underneath. And I'm gonna get a little bit more of my flexible fiber. And I really find it important to use some kind of puck, so some kind of product that has style memory when you're doing kind of a tighter, cleaner braid, especially so that you can get that control. So I'm gonna start with my two larger pieces in one hand and then my little piece off to the side. And I'm gonna go over and under. Okay, so I'm wrapped around my first side and then I went underneath my other side. And then I'm gonna come back over. So from the outside, and then I'm gonna go under this side. So I'm creating a figure eight in between my two larger sections here. And I'm just gonna continue doing this. When I first saw this, I was like, whoa, that looks really complicated. But then once you really break it down, it's pretty simple. I feel like that's always the case with braids. They look very scary and intimidating, until you kind of play around with them and figure out they're not so bad. Okay, so I'm just gonna continue going from outside over, inside under. Now when I start to lose my ends, so see how this is starting to get kind of small and I haven't really made as much braid as I want to, I'm gonna take a tiny bit of my left side here and I'm gonna combine that with that little strand and then I'm gonna continue on. So then I'm gonna go under. And over. I'm gonna keep creating that braid. Okay, starting to see it come together.
Everyone is loving it.
Yay, so fun. This is, I think, one of the coolest looking braids. So I'm gonna pick up a little bit from this side too, just to give myself a little bit more length. And keep my sides consistent. It's all about consistency.
Many people are saying you're doing a great job explaining this.
Oh, good.
I can't wait to try it.
Oh, I'm so excited. And you know what? You guys have to try it right away because I'm a person that I have to put it into practice right off the bat or else I forget what I'm doing. Okay. So again, my end's getting a little small, so I want to get a little bit from the outside. Combine it.
Ooh, we have a great question. Would you start the infinity braid the same way from a ponytail?
Ooh, good question. If it was like already in an elastic ponytail, I'm guessing. And yes, I would.
But this one you did not start from an elastic.
No, this one I just started just right out from my hand. I don't have any elastic securing it because I also want to come back through and I'm going to pinch and pull to give her a little bit more movement through the top.
Chrissy is so excited to try. Homecoming is right around the corner.
Oh, I love it. Oh my gosh. To use this on. And what a simple just look. I think that this just looks so pretty. So before I go through, I am going to use this in my little end here, and I'm just going to clip to secure it, and I'm going to go back through, and I know I'm going to pinch and pull, and you could do this before, but I just wanted to show you how easy it is, because this is just kind of pulling out in between the braid. I'm just going to kind of pinch and pull to give her kind of a softer look. I don't want her to look flat. I want her to have a little bit of volume, and the pinch and pull method is always the way to go through the top.
Also to make it look more worn, is not as too overly polished as well.
Exactly. Right? Even though we're going for a more polished style and this is kind of a more polished braid, it's not so deconstructed. I still like to see a little bit of movement and texture in there. And if I have a little, so I had a little section right there that I pulled a little bit too much. I like to use my rat tail comb, just that tail, and just push it right back in.
If you have too much hair coming out?
Yeah, so if I over pull something, I can just smooth it back in and pinch it in.
That's a great tip.
Cool. So now that I'm liking how she's looking here, I want to check it out in the mirror too. So just always be sure that you're making it nice and balanced. But I'm loving that.
Great. Bianca says, I think having long nails definitely will help with this. You're loving your nails.
Well, thank you. I'm really loving this polish, I'll be honest. I did it because I knew that my hands were going to be on display today. But nails definitely help. So I'm just going through and perfecting. So now that I have the braid where I want it.
Sarah's asking, what would you typically charge for this? She says, ooh. I know my demographics are different, but how much would you charge?
Definitely. So, you know, prices are always tough. It's always tough to give like a roundabout kind of answer. I think that you definitely need to charge what you feel you're worth. Just having continued education definitely helps up your value too, because you're just kind of perfecting your craft. So I would say, you know, look around at wherever you are located And make sure that your prices are competitive. You don't want to go way off the charts, but you want to definitely be getting what you're worth. And I think that all of you guys tuning in right now are really taking your education seriously. And I think that your clients like to hear that. So let them know that, you know, you're going in and you're really perfecting your craft and, oh, I learned this new technique and I really want to try it on you, because that gets them excited too. So I can't give like a certain number. I know that's probably not the answer you want to hear, but just acknowledge how much you're worth. You're probably worth more than you're charging. I can tell you that much. So all I did here was I went ahead and I put a rubber band, just a little elastic right around, and then I'm just kind of pushing my braid back down to hide it. So it's nice and secured. That hairstyle's not going anywhere. So if she's going to homecoming and she's dancing around and having an, you know, crazy night, it's not going to move. But it's also keeping that nice softness up through the top too. Making a little bit more there. So even look how pretty that is. I always think with half up, half down styles, I like to really focus on a beautiful curl. So whether it be a really glamorous wave like this, or if you're going in with more of a beachy effect, whenever I create a beachy curl, I like to kind of go in there and do opposite ways. So maybe I'll do one curl kind of going towards the face and then one curl going back away. That gives a more random effect rather than making this kind of like uniform wave. So just depending on what you're looking for in terms of your guests and what their preference is, you can really change that up. But I love an infinity braid because I think it looks really fun and fresh. And it's a little bit different, but it's also, I don't know, a little bit more cleaner and kind of a departure from a lot of the like really fluffy braids that we're seeing, which I love to create too, but it's fun to have some options. I'm gonna go in just with a little bit more of my color maintenance spray. And I like this too because it's kind of double duty. Whenever I'm doing an up style, I like to really use something that's a softer hold until I really build up my style and perfect it, and then I'll go in with a finishing spray. So I'll probably finish off her whole style with Volume Spray 25. But right now I'm still working on it, I'm still perfecting it and making sure that I'm liking how everything looks before I go in and solidify. Okay, right. So now that we have, oh, did you have another question? Sorry.
Oh no, I just want to fully show the whole look. Looks gorgeous.
So really beautiful. Fun. I think that so many, especially girls in high school that have like this long, gorgeous hair, really kind of want to show off that length, but maybe with a style that's a little bit more fun. So I think this is a really easy way to kind of elevate something. I think that a lot of girls that come in will just ask for their hair to be curled, and I love to go, hey, why don't we like throw in like a fun little braid or something that'll kind of accent it or keep it away from your face or just keep your style a little bit more solidified through the evening. So always make sure to give your guests recommendations, because if you don't, they're gonna get bored. Okay, so now that we have our half up, half down style, I wanna transition to this into a full up style. Does that sound fun?
So fun.
I love it. So I'm gonna go in first, and so right below, I'm gonna create kind of a upside down triangle. And that's gonna go all the way down to her nape. So I'm going to first start with this diagonal back. And let's just do a little clip there. I'm going to do the same thing on the opposite side. Just creating a little inverted triangle right below where my infinity braid was. I'm gonna go through and just really softly, I'm not gonna really brush very hard because I don't wanna pull down any of my detail that I created, but I'm just gonna smooth this out a little bit. And I'm gonna take another little elastic And I'm going to come all the way down. So using low elevation. Let me clip that. I want to make sure that she's nice and balanced. Always make sure you have your balance. So feel your sides. They should have similar density.
Someone is asking, what is the instructor's Instagram name?
Oh, it's Chelsey Ellis Hair, and we might need to put that in the comments because I was given a difficult spelling of Chelsey. It's not Chelsey with an A, it's Chelsey with a Y. So where the A would normally be is a Y. And then my last name is Ellis, just like the island. And Hair, all one word.
So, it's in the comments.
Lovely. I'm going to make a little loop right here, and I'm pinning close down towards the bottom. So low elevation, and I've just created a little loop there. So nothing crazy, but I just want to kind of pin those ends up. And I like to use that a lot when I'm trying to hide the ends or if I'm going to pin it up straight. So I'm going to come up from underneath, and I'm just going to turn this. So I'm almost giving her like a faux bob. Look how cute. This would be really fun to put even just like some little pieces over the top, but I'm just going to take this, roll it up, and pin it underneath. So I'm going to take one pin on each side. I don't like to use a ton of bobby pins because I hate it when clients have to go and try and dig for all of their bobby pins and they're like falling out in the shower weeks later. So I'm just going to crisscross them to really lock them in. I'm just spraying with a little bit more of my color maintenance spray. And I'm just gonna spread that hair out a little bit. And I'm also kind of pulling it apart to kind of accentuate that wave that we put in. You guys see how that's kind of bringing that wave back?
Someone's asking, can you show me the front of the bottle that you're using?
Oh, of
course. She's going to pick it up tomorrow.
Yeah. Yes. So this is what it looks like. And what I really love about this spray too is it has kind of a nice dry finish, but it's still very shiny. I especially like to use something that's a little bit more dry when I'm kind of working with it and building it, especially if I'm pairing it with different texturizing products. So I really love using my fiber, which is already has a little bit of moisture. It's a little bit more fibrous, kind of like that sticky tacky kind of feel. I like something that's going to be a little bit dry layered on top of it. Okay, so now I have that set. And I still have these two side sections here. So I have these two guys, and if you missed, if we look underneath, it's coming all the way down to the corner of the nape. So that whole back section. So now I'm gonna start by taking my tail comb. And I'm going to take diagonal forward sections. And if your client wants to have any little pieces kind of hanging out, I love to do the little shake method to make it look a little bit more natural. So I'll hold that front section and then I'll just kind of shake this out. See how like these little pieces fall and it just looks nice and soft. It doesn't look so, I don't know, perfect or like I kind of made everything all symmetrical. It just looks like it would just kind of a breeze hit it and made these little tendrils fall down. So I'm taking again just a little bit of my flexible fiber and I'm gonna pull that through to kind of smooth this section out. a good tip whenever you're using like a pomade or a fiber or a taffy, if you want to really disperse the product, I like to get something with kind of a tighter bristle. So this little nylon brush, and just pulling through will really help get those little flyaways. And I'm going to come all the way back and I'm going to cross over my braid. I want to let a little bit of it kind of peek through because that's a fun little detail, right? So I'm going to take this first one and I'm just going to pin that in. And I don't like to open up my bobby pins because what'll happen is if I open them up, sometimes they'll grab too much hair and they'll start sliding back out. I bet that has happened to everybody before. They're really only supposed to hold this much hair, what you see in the eye. So what I like to do instead is I like to use the longer arm and I like to kind of pick up and weave the hair and then just push my pin in. That'll just really help secure it.
Sarah is asking, how many pumps of the fiber should you use?
Oh, so the fiber comes in this little pot. So it comes just like this. And I usually just get like just enough for like one fingertip. And then I'll kind of disperse it through my fingers to get just like a nice little sheen on them. So nothing too, too strong. Because I am layering that in there too. So I'm gonna go to the opposite side. I'm going to take another diagonal forward section. So again, I kind of want to use my little shakeout method, and I do really want to leave this kind of, let me turn her around so you can see a little bit better in the front. Really want to leave this piece down because I think that that just brings like such a beautiful like face framing section right around her face. And we'll kind of play with that a little bit later. But if I want to get some more falling out, I'm just going to kind of shake it and let that fall. And she does have some little baby hairs like we all do. So that's really where that fiber comes into play. So again, hardly any, if you can see on that one finger. And then I'm just going to disperse it on the other ones just to emulsify it. And I'm gonna go in with my brush again and then just comb that through. And I'm gonna come back over and crisscross over my braid. I'm just gonna weave that pin in there and stick it right by the other one. And now that I have those two crisscrossing the back, down just a little bit, perfect. I'm gonna come in now with another spray. So this one is really, really cool. If you guys haven't tried this yet, oops, my hands are slippery from my fiber. First. Okay. So this one is our alcohol-free shaping spray. So this is a firm hold, but there's no alcohol in it, guys, and it is an aerosol, which I think is so cool. It's so fantastic for natural curly hair because curly hair, we're always looking for a little bit more moisture, right? We're looking to add more moisture into the hair so we keep it from looking frizzy. But what I love is using this for up styles when I'm looking to create kind of like any kind of S shapes or something that's really nice and smooth, because it does give me just a little bit of time to go in and smooth it before it dries. And what I really love to use is, if, I don't know if you guys have ever seen one of these. This is a little kabuki brush. Super cool, right? And you don't need a really expensive one. You're going to be putting a lot of product on it. So I do kind of go through these quite a bit. When they get a little bit stocked up with product, they're time to go. So I do like to spray a little bit of product on there. And the shaping spray is the best because it does, like I said, stay a little bit more wet. And I like to just brush it right along the top of my section. And what that does is it helps get all those little flyaways without really pushing the hair and making it look overworked. So it is really cool for that. So I'm just gonna spray a little bit more on, just a little bit of mist. And then bring over on the other side. If you guys have ever gone and tried to add more hairspray on and it gets really stiff or too crunchy, this is a really good method, is using just a little kabuki brush and brushing it on really nice and soft. And that way it doesn't stick to your fingers when you're trying to pull away from it.
They have those kabuki brushes at Cosmoprof, correct? There's tons of different ones there.
Yes, definitely. Yeah, you could definitely pick one of those up, and they're so handy. So I'm just locking in those two little pins down there just so I can have a little bit of a tighter hold.
Ooh, we have another great question. In your life, how long are you booking this in the salon from start to finish?
From start to finish, if I'm doing a whole set with the curls, and sometimes I might not do that. I think that one thing we do too much is we'll do too much setting of the whole head if not a lot of their curl is gonna show. So in this case, I would normally probably book up styles for 45 minutes to an hour, depending on the occasion. With brides, I like to book a little bit more time. If it's a homecoming or something that's like a prom, like maybe 45 minutes is enough. Just depending on how comfortable you feel, you definitely want enough time for yourself. Everyone's gonna be different. So I'm gonna go again to the opposite side, and I'm gonna take another diagonal forward section. I'm gonna get my flexible fiber. So another good tip is if I'm going all the way up with the hair, obviously I wanted to showcase a couple of different things tonight. If I was just going to put her hair all up, I might only spend maybe like 10 minutes curling her whole head, not putting in like a perfect curl, because that curl's not going to show. It's all going to be pinned up, so it's going to look a little bit different, right? So I'm going to crisscross this. And again, just take my pin right underneath. And I kind of love having that little infinity braid in there too, because I'm kind of sticking my pin to the back of it, which is help locking it in, but it also gives it this like cool little peekaboo effect. Isn't that fun, guys? I just love that. Kind of like a little surprise, just a little treat. And then I'm gonna go in with my alcohol-free shaping spray again. Just a tiny little mist. You don't need a lot, but it really does help kind of polish that hair. Just kind of gives it a nice polished look to it. And I'm just gonna go back and forth until I run out of hair. So again, over to the opposite side. And a little bit of my fiber. Really just making ribbons throughout the hair. And you'll really want to brush through anytime you use something that's a putty, again, or a pomade, because it really helps disperse the product and it doesn't give you like a wet spot. Sometimes if you just leave like a chunk of product, it can look like a little wet spot or a little dot in her hair color, and we don't want that. Again, just crisscrossing over and weaving my pin in. See how we're creating almost like this braided effect on top of the other braid? I love that. I think that's really cool.
Everyone thinks it looks gorgeous.
Yeah. Well, I'm so excited for the holidays, and I think that there's still, even though we're kind of coming out of wedding season, I think there's still a lot of winter weddings that are probably coming up, and a lot of different things. Homecoming, winter ball. I mean, you could really make this as simple or as intricate as you want. It doesn't have to have so much detail to it. And like I said, just the half up, half down is so fun too. Kind of give them a little something different. Give them options, right? I'm all about options. Okay, so I'm coming down to loosen. I just want to make sure that I'm keeping consistency. So with the remaining hair that I have, I want to make sure that my pieces are about the same size. I have a bad habit of always wanting to go through and perfect my style while I'm still working on it. One good tip that I love to share is wait until your style is all finished. Once you have it all in place, then you can go back to the beginning. And if you have little areas that you want to tweak or perfect, like see, I'm seeing a little gap right here. I might want to go up and kind of fill that in, but I'm going to wait until I'm all done. Because if you just keep nitpicking everything that you're doing, it's going to really eat up your timing and probably make you spend a lot more time on a style than maybe what you could have if you would have just set it first.
Chantel is asking, what kind of brush are you using to smooth out each of those pieces?
This is just a little tease brush. So this is also from Cosmoprof. I love these ones because they're really nice and thin. So it's three rows, and there's that center row is a little bit longer, so it kind of helps me with detailing, if you guys can see that. Helps me with detailing, as well as smoothing and dispersing product throughout. So I really love using that one for updos. That's a definite must-have in your kit. Okay, so down on the other side. Out my section, and you'll notice I'm just letting the ends kind of free fall right on the bottom. I'm not going to worry about those quite yet. Just gonna weave that over the top. Okay, and I have two more pieces left. Look at how cute this is even looking right now. Like even if we just took these ones and pinned them up, there's like so many different ways that you can make this your own. I love to keep with that kind of versatility. So I'm gonna go in with my last pieces. And every time I pick up a new piece, I'm just dotting my finger in my flexible fiber just to get a little bit of control. But again, you don't need a lot.
If anyone has any questions, please feel free to ask Chelsea. She's here to answer them.
Yes, thank you for everybody who's been asking questions. Guys have been asking some good ones. Okay, and then my last long piece.
Sarah is asking, how would you adjust this look for a bride with a veil?
Oh, you know what? This is actually a great style for somebody with a veil. It just depends on where they're gonna wear it. What I might do is like ponytail this center section first and then take two wider sections on the side. That way I have something secure right here that I can go in and put like their fascinator or their comb. That would probably be a perfect way, but it does have like a nice little section right here that you could definitely put a veil in. Okay. That's always really a great question to ask anytime you're doing a bridal trial. I request them to bring in either their hairpiece or if they're considering wearing a hairpiece or a veil. It's just a good idea to kind of figure out where you're going to make it work.
And we had a couple questions. Are you using any of those hairpieces that are at the bottom?
I am. I'm leaving them out right now. I'm just letting the ends kind of hang down first.
And then for the veil, you can also put it underneath.
Oh, definitely. Right? Yeah.
That would be gorgeous for this too.
That would be really pretty, like coming from below. Oh, I'd love that.
Yeah, then you can see all the updo as well.
Totally, you can see all that detail. Okay, so now that I have all of those ends kind of picked up, I just have these pieces kind of hanging out. So if I want to show off more texture, what I can do is I can start kind of pinning them throughout. But since I want to keep this a little bit more like a finished, almost like a bun underneath, I'm going to go and smooth these ends out really gently. So I'm not going to pull too hard because I don't want to pull out all of that detail that I just worked really hard to get. And I'm just gonna take this section and I'm gonna have you tilt down just a little bit. Perfect. Come down throughout down here and I'm just gonna pin up right to the side. So I'm kinda gonna fill out this bun here.
We have someone who's asking, how does our flexible fiber differ from our texturizing taffy?
Oh, really good question. They're very similar. So our texturizing taffy is in our platinum line. Our flexible fiber has a hold of an 11, so a little bit lower than the texturizing taffy is at a 13, but they both have a really nice high shine finish. This one I feel like is a little bit more kind of a softer hold, which is nice, but they're very, very similar. I would say they're very similar products. I love to use the flexible fiber because it also kind of builds up hair density a little bit, which is very cool. It's great for short haircuts, for pixie cuts, men's styles. I can't stress how much I love it. I mean, of course I have short hair, so I love anything in a puck, but. Okay, so I'm gonna bring this one off to the side too. So I'm just rolling it underneath and then I'm just gonna pin over to the side.
Someone is asking, what about the holes by the braid?
Oh, I'm gonna finish those once I'm all done with my style. So again, that's something that I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna detail right at the end. Good questions. So now I'm going to go through, and once I have my style all solidified, now I can go in and do a little bit more detailing, right? So if I see like a little hole right here, I'm just going to pull this curl. See how I have like a little hole right here? I'm just going to reposition and go in. The reason why I don't like to detail as I go is really because sometimes those little imperfections kind of work for you and you don't see it until everything's done and you see the big picture. So it's important to just wait it out until you see kind of your style all coming together. So now I'm gonna come up and I'm just gonna use a little bit of my spray to kind of really hold up and solidify there. And I love to use styling pins. So I don't know if you guys like to use styling pins. This is one item I never used in my kit when I first started doing styles, and I just don't know how I did it without it anymore. when I think about pins, so the difference between a styling pin and a bobby pin is really the tension, right? So we see this one's a lot tighter, and this one has that nice little gap in between. What the bobby pins are gonna do is they're gonna help our foundation of our style. So they're gonna really hold everything together. Our styling pins are gonna go in and help us a little bit more with soft detail. They're also a lot easier to take out of the hair. So let's say you kind of like place something and you didn't like how that looked. It's easy to kind of pop it back out and you don't ruin everything. With a bobby pin, it can kind of grab and then pull pieces out, and then you're worried about just completely ruining your style, right? So I'm gonna go in with my styling pin. I'm just gonna give it a little twist. Just to help cover up that little hole there. I just love them, they work just like magic, right? So again, like see how this thing is sticking up right here? I don't love that. So I'm gonna bring that down and I'm just gonna go in with my little pin. Just push that right through. And I always want to take a look at my style from every angle and really make sure, because upstyling, it's a 360 view. It's not just the back, it's not just the side, it's not just the front. You really want to make sure that it has a good balance all the way throughout. All right, guys, so I'm just starting to finish up, just doing those little details. Please ask me any questions that you guys might have about this style or upstyling or really anything hair related. But I really just love how we did that low pony and then balled it underneath, because it gave us kind of like this textured bun. I like kind of the juxtaposition of having like the smooth sides, having the waves on top, and having like a little bit of wildness underneath. It's kind of cool having a play on both of those. And then you can always come back through, and if you feel like you want to loosen up a little bit, you can definitely do that.
It's gorgeous.
And then with any little bit of fiber that I kind of still have on my hands, I like to go through the front and kind of play with these pieces. Maybe just give them a little bit of definition. So again, they still look soft, but they won't get frizzy or drop throughout the night. It'll give them just a little bit of hold.
Beautiful.
I'm gonna go through and just kind of brush out this front. And this is also a great style if your client has a fringe or something that they wanna maintain. I get a lot of questions for that, like how do I kind of make this for my client that has a fringe? This is a great style to incorporate a fringe with.
It's gorgeous. Everyone's loving it.
Me too. Jenny, you gotta go somewhere now.
Chantel saying, this is a great look for clients with long hair.
Oh, yes. And really, I love the security that that braid brings in the back. I'm really just finessing this little front area. And also, using styling pins around the hairline, or to get like a fringe kind of controlled, but not looking too pulled, I think is always the case, because like this might bother her throughout the night. Some people like to have that security. They need that little security blanket. But if we wanted to just give her a little bit of control, you can just sneak that guy in there. Get him in there a little bit better. He's too sneaky. But see how easy it is when I like don't like how it's looking, I can really just pull it right back out and it didn't ruin my style here.
Anything. That's perfect.
that would still allow me to give her something nice and soft, but now she's got a little bit of security there.
Great tip.
All right, let's spin her around and see how she looks. Ah, I love it. Helps when your client is just gorgeous too. So I'm really just looking at every little angle. So making sure that I'm liking the height there. Liking how everything's coming into play in the back. I'm liking that balance throughout.
So let's say she didn't like the height of it. How would you bring it back down? Ooh, what would be your tips for that?
Great question. Another time that I love to use styling pins is if I'm getting a little bit, if afterwards, even though she looked at the style, we all know that we have those clients sometimes that at the end of everything, they're like, it's too big here. It's too poofy. So I really like to come in with my styling pins and even just like pull the hair down a little bit and tuck it away. Or if it's kind of behaving in a little manner that I'm not thrilled about, this is another way to really solidify it. But it's a nice option if somebody's like, oh, it's a little bit too poofy. They want to bring down the poof factor a little bit. You can definitely do it like this. Good question.
Everyone is loving it.
But styling pins are really going to be your best friend. If you don't use them, you really need to pick up a pack of them and start playing because they are just so handy, especially when you just want a little bit of soft hold. Again, any little frizzies I'm seeing. But voila, she's all done.
Beautiful.
And if you guys want to check out her before and after with her color, I will be posting that on my Instagram page tonight so that you guys can see that. And Kenra Professional will also be posting it, so you guys can check it out on either page. But that pretty much sums it up, unless anyone has any other questions. I had such a good time with you guys tonight. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you even just picked up one little tip, or maybe, you know, a new product that's going to be your favorite.
Awesome. Would you mind quickly going through the products that you did use, just in case for people tuning in halfway through?
Definitely. So let's talk a couple of products that we used tonight. So we did set with our Color Maintenance Thermal Spray. So this was used to protect her color during heat styling. Again, it's going to protect that color up to 25 passes. So 25 heat styles, it's going to protect it and really lock in the vibrancy. The next one we use, I'm trying to do them in order of how I used them. And then we had our dry oil conditioning mist. So this one is going to go in and give instant silkiness and softness to the hair, as well as an unparalleled shine. We then went in with a little bit of our dry volume burst. So this was used to create this lovely texture up at the top and really give her some nice height without having to go in and do any teasing. That was one thing, we didn't do any teasing in her hair today. We also used our flexible fiber for our infinity braid and also all of our little pieces that we crossed over. And then last but not least, we had our alcohol-free shaping spray. So again, love to say, use this for curly hair and for shaping updos. Probably my two favorite things. Curly clients just love it because it really keeps in that moisture. And it has a hold of 21, which is pretty high. So it's more of a medium firm hold. It's really gonna lock in their style. Fantastic. I just want to thank CosmoProf and thank all of you guys that joined. I had so much fun, and follow us on Instagram and on Facebook and reach out with any more questions.